To present our next award, the Vice President from the Southern Region, Mr. Jim Marinetti.
Thank you, Trish. August 11th, 2017. Andrew White, Tommy Vaughn, Patrick Johnson, Darren Tumelson, Josh Hall, Jeremiah Lee from Memphis Center. They came together as a team and were the epitome of professionalism in everything that we've been listening to for the past couple days here at this wonderful conference. Loss of control of an aircraft is one of the most terrifying things a GA pilot can experience. When the pilot of a Piper Cheyenne reported mechanical problems, he decided to end his flight early and land at the closest airport at Greenwood, Mississippi. After multiple low passes, the tower controllers confirmed that his landing gear was not extended. This was just the start to a 2.5 hour ordeal where he experienced locked flight controls, autopilot issues, loss of pitch control, and hydraulic failure. In the lower right corner of the following video, you will see the flight-aware playback of the flight. The radar replay and the flight-aware playback are not perfectly synced, but it should give you an idea of just how far and how long this flight took. It covered over 300 miles to land, and it was just 38 miles from his original departure point. Please play the video.
Full emergency.
113 Roman Charlie, Roger, it's been advised. Greenwood's altimeter again is a 3003.
Is there any way you could get emergency procedure book on this airplane? It disappeared out of the airplane. Center, is that Greenville on my left?
113 Roman Charlie, yes sir. Greenwood Airport is there on your left.
All right, can you advise tower? I'm going to do a little flyby, see if I've got any gears at all. I just got horns going off everywhere.
Yes, sir. They are on the other line right now with the tower. They're going to give us a gear check here in just a moment.
All right, I'll put it on a ground tower.
From 113 Roman Charlie, a tower advises that they do not have a gear indication down yet for you, so no gear down yet. From 113 Roman Charlie, radar contact is lost. Just tell me your altitude.
No, you took it out of here. It's out of the airplane. You've taken it out of here. Hello. Sorry. I was trying to get the emergency book. Are you back with me?
113 Roman Charlie, Center's got you loud and clear. What's your altitude?
I'm out of 400, going to 5.
113 Roman Charlie, Roger.
What'd they say about my gears?
They said that no gear indication currently.
You might as well go ahead and get the fire and stuff out of here. I guess, hell, I don't know what to tell you guys to do right at the moment.
3 Roman Charlie, I believe they've already been called. I can double check on that again, and we'll just make sure they've got the emergency systems standing by in the case that we need to do a gear up landing. 113 Romeo Charlie, you familiar with the location of your emergency gear hand pump?
Yeah, hang on. I got another issue. Hang on.
3 Romeo Charlie, I missed that last part.
I've got full control lock. I can't even get into the damn control. Something's in the electrical system.
113 Romeo Charlie, are you able to make any control inputs at all, left or right?
I can't do anything.
113 Romeo Charlie, are you able to maintain altitude?
Don't know.
113 Romeo Charlie, showing you a slow left-hand turn. Are you able to regain some control input?
Negative.
Okay. Are you able to do differential thrust?
Fucking in the clouds now. I don't know.
113 Romeo Charlie, we've got a hold of Frank, who's going to be going up to the tower there at Greenwood. We're going to keep the eye on you here. Have you got a secondary radio with you?
No, I can go to the other radio. Both of you on. God damn it, I'm going to descent now.
113 Romeo Charlie, yes, sir. I actually got a 2,800. Just let's focus on maintain your altitude first. Let's keep you in the air since you've got some fuel left. Let's keep you in the air as long as we can and try to troubleshoot this from this angle here. And Mr. Frank will be on the other radio at Greenwood Tower, and they'll be able to talk to you from there.
Hey, Center, Cheyenne 113 Romeo Charlie.
Cheyenne 3 Romeo Charlie, go ahead, sir.
Yeah, it's going crazy. They're trying to figure it out. I guess you can see it goes up. It goes down to 4,600, then it goes back up to 4,000, then it turns a left bank turn, and then it'll turn back to the right.
We have somebody from another area on the line with Piper directly, and they're going to try to run through a troubleshoot for us and see if there's something else that we can get relayed to you from them.
Thank you very much. If you guys have got Piper on the phone, they're thinking I've got a runaway tram is what they're thinking. That's locked the autopilot up. Ask Piper if that's possible, okay?
113 Romeo Charlie, the question's being posed right now. I've got another assistant here on the phone directly with Piper. He's listening in and he's relaying your questions directly to them.
Okay. Thank you.
Oh no. We're not done yet. No. Unable to locate the plane's emergency manual. Controllers were able to contact a friend of the pilot's and known pilot of the aircraft, and by calling Piper's customer service line, eventually got Piper's chief pilot on the line. Piper stayed in contact with the center for the remainder of the flight. Together, they determined that the aircraft's autopilot would not disengage, causing the multiple mechanical failures and essentially rendering the pilot unable to control his aircraft.
Three Romeo Charlie, this is the guy talking to Piper right now. He said you got a runway trim and the autopilot's locked up. Is the autopilot actually disconnected at this time?
Yes, sir. I'll give you guys all the information. We've recycled the autopilot. I've taken it out. I've unplugged the flight director. I've turned the generators off. I've turned the master off, and it's completely locked. And tell them it's just weird. I go into a left turn, and then it somehow I go back into a right turn. And I've got zero control of it. I mean, I've got rudders, that's it. The manual trim, I can't move it. I can't move the yoke left or right or up and down.
Center 3 Romeo Charlie, are you able, like when it starts rolling, are you able to force the yoke level?
I got zero control of it. It seems to level itself up and down. I don't know. The trim tab is not moving at all. I mean, it's not moving manually. It's not moving automatically like it did with the autopilot.
Okay. Piper's trying to track down one of their test pilots for the airplane.
All right. Thanks.
Air 3 Romeo Charlie, if you're able, see if you can get your aircraft to start turning towards the north. You got some heavy to extreme precipitation, 12 o'clock, about 25 miles we want to keep you away from.
Center, 113 Romeo Charlie, I'm pushing some right rudder on it to see if I can get a little bit of a right turn on it. Am I catching anything? I mean, I'm showing a tad bit of a turn.
3 Romeo Charlie, it's a slow turn, but it does indicate a slow turn on my side as well.
I've got severe red in front of me at 30 miles.
Jackson, poke on the center.
I'm on my left rudder. I'm trying to get around, but it's not doing much.
Air 3 Romeo Charlie, Piper's saying you should be able to put some muscle into the yoke with no issues. See if you can put some effort into it and see if you can't get that right turn started.
All right, how much muscle ask them? 10 pounds or 200?
Air 3 Romeo Charlie, Piper's saying put as much muscle into it as it takes. You won't do any damage.
If you can arrest the turn and try not to come any further south, we're going to keep you away from most of this precipitation that we're that's looming out ahead and within about 20 miles of you. For 113 Romeo Charlie, if you're you want to try to go all the way back to Greenwood and burn some extra fuel, you're looking to set it down at a little bit more of a major airport with additional services available.
I'm by myself. It doesn't matter. We'll just go to Greenwood. Let's not go into metropolitan area.
Okay. Number 3 Romeo Charlie, you're still looking good. Looks like you're maintaining altitude and heading. That's about 2 or 3 minutes out pretty consistently. This is looking a lot better.
Yeah, I'm flying it with my knees now. I got nothing left in my arms, so.
Yeah, we're going to need those here once we get to a little bit further inbound if there are any other necessary control inputs. Number 3 Romeo Charlie, have we determined about how many pumps or how long it'll take for you to get that gear down manually?
No, I haven't got there yet. I don't know. I'll try that.
How much fuel have you got remaining?
I still got a half tank. But I can't stay up here for another 2 hours. It'll kill me.
Mr. Romeo Charlie, we're going to need some of that arm strength to do some pumping to get that gear down, though, whenever you're feeling up to it.
All right. I got the gears down now. I've hit the gears. They went down. All kinds of life. I think I'm going to throw up on top of everything else. Sorry, guys.
Mr. Romeo Charlie, if from my point of view, you're doing great. We're keeping up. Your altitude looks good. Your speed looks good. Looks like you're coming back around through the north. And we understand you're tired. And we're going to stay with you here until this is all over. 113 Romeo Charlie, we just got back in touch with the tower. They're going to ensure visually that they've got a gear down indication visually for you as well. We understand that you do have three green indications on the in the flight deck, and we want to make sure that we've got the visual cue as well.
All right, sounds good. At this point, I don't think we can do anything. If they're not down, we'll have to belly it in. I think I got the airport to my left. Would that be right about 11 o'clock?
Yes, sir, 11 o'clock and about 15 miles.
I'll see if I can manhandle this bitch.
That's 3 Romeo Charlie. Roger, you're cleared for an approach into Greenwood. And I'll take that, but you do have the field in sight. You're going to be with me all the way in.
All right. Okay. It looks like to me I've got to come back to the right pretty soon. Is that right?
I think anything to the right is going to put you a little bit short, but that's just according to the radar. If you think you need to come to the right a little bit, I'll leave the flying up to you at your perspective.
You've been doing a good job. I'm working with you.
3 Romeo Charlie, runway 36, tower says you are cleared to land. Equipment services are standing by.
You're probably about as tired as I am. All right, I still don't have the airport, so we're going to have to find it here, guys.
3 Romeo Charlie, you do not yet have the airport?
No, I don't. I'm sorry. I don't.
Okay, number 113 Romeo Charlie, if you can make a right-hand turn to heading of a 360, the airport is 9 miles at 1 o'clock.
All right, I think I might have it. Ask Piper,
have the lights on high.
Take this thing down with no flaps, Doug.
Number 3 Romeo Charlie, Piper's saying whatever speed gives you the best pitch control of the aircraft is the speed you should fly.
I've got the runway.
113 Romeo Charlie, roger. Again, you are cleared to land on runway 36.
All right, thank you, guys. I'll talk to you in a minute. All right, and the yoke's still locked. It's all the way to the left.
Glad you arrived safe. It's good to hear.
How are you?
Hey, great job, 3 Romeo Charlie. Great job, great job.
Now. Please welcome me in joining and welcoming the recipients of the 2018 Southern Region Archie League Medal of Safety Award winners, the incredible team from Memphis Center.
I think that video kind of speaks for itself. It's one of the most intense days that I know I've ever worked, and without these guys next to me, it could have had a much different outcome. I've been coming to CFS since 2015, and I've noticed two recurring themes being emphasized each year: collaboration and communication. I believe that this event showed what can happen when a team communicates effectively and collaborates to produce a positive outcome. I personally like to thank Tommy and Patrick, Josh, Jeremy, and Darren. It wouldn't have been possible to complete this without you and your hard work make all the difference. Special thanks to Paul and Trish and all the NACA members, all the NACA family out there for this event, and mostly importantly, my wife Jennifer, who makes every day possible for me. Thanks, guys.
I'll keep it pretty sweet, but obviously everybody heard Andrew on the R side. He did an absolutely incredible job. I don't know that I would have wanted to be in his shoes in that moment, but he did pretty amazing. Just wanted to thank a couple people. First, my dad. When I first joined the military and went in the infantry, wanted to be a ranger and kick in doors. And I think basically the nice way of putting it, he kept telling me for about 2 years, you need to get off my couch and make some real money. And he's a retired controller from Memphis Center. He pushed me that way. And he's here tonight, right over there. And then my wife, you know, for hanging in there with me for through military training, two deployments, trying to get here to the FA. And I've been here in the FA for 6 years, and she's been there all along, and she does an amazing job. And she's right over there. She's absolutely gorgeous. And the third people to thank would just these guys right here. I mean, you know, just like we're talking about collaboration, I mean, this was an unbelievable experience because once it started happening, we pulled in controllers. The entire area, you know, went from being the typical center controllers, joking around, having a good time, and all of a sudden you got guys peeling off sectors, taking over frequencies so Andrew could do his job and not have to talk to other planes. So, you know, these guys really did a great job, and yeah, that's what I got. Thanks.